in Poland. He's there for a two-day NATO meeting, but before doing anything with that, he felt the need to speak to the nation back here at home about what's happened over the last 2 days here. Two more police shootings of African-American men. You can see protests around the country right now in several cities around the country. We're going to keep our eye on those all night. Director Spike Lee has appeared on this program many times. Unfortunately, it's often in the aftermath of tragic incidents like the one we're seeing right now. We're always grateful to hear his perspective. He joins us now along with CNN political commentator and former Obama administration official Van Jones. We're going to continue to keep our eye on these protests, these crowds that are growing around the country. Pretty remarkable pictures from around the country. Spike, I want to ask you first about what the president did there. He spoke for 16 minutes. He clearly wanted to get something off his chest there. There were a few things he said. Number one, we can do better. He said that several times. Number two, he wanted to lay out the facts about law enforcement and African-Americans. Still law, African-Americans shot by police at a 2.5 times higher rate than African-Americans. And number three, I think he wanted to frame this discussion maybe in a different way. He suggested outright that just by saying Black Lives Matter, you're not saying that blue lives, the lives of police, don't matter.
Well, I applaud President Obama for his speech. I thought it was magnificent. In the past, he's been kind of like, maybe hesitant to step out in front, maybe except for the when Trayvon, I'm gonna say he got murdered, when Trayvon got murdered. And I'm very proud, again, we're being redundant. I think the president nailed it. He talked about the stats that these things are just happening out of thin air. I would like to add, we've had some tough history, and he said vestiges that passed. I would have used the word slavery. Tough history, vested past. Let's use real words. Slavery, that's the stuff we have not dealt with in this country, and that's why we're still in the predicament that we're in.
The president did use some real words, though. He essentially said, this is real. This is a thing. Right. Governor Mark Dayton of Minnesota said, you know, people ask me, would this have happened had they been white passengers in the car in Minnesota? And the governor, the white governor of Minnesota, said, no, I don't think so.
Mark Daly, I think.
Mark Dayton. Are those Dayton. The real words you're looking for?
I want to applaud the governor of Minnesota because I know already the police are killing his character. I don't mean to use the word killing, and that's not the word to use, but I think he was being honest. And
it's tough.
I mean, Diamond tough. Reynolds, I've never seen anything like that before in my life. And I think that what she did was very heroic. And we have to, I think people are missing, her daughter was in the back seat.
Diamond Reynolds is the fiance of Philando Castile,
right.
The man
4 years old, and how is she being traumatized, for the rest of her life?
She live streamed on Facebook what was happening in that car and narrated it while it was happening.
You know, with the technology, because I've always believed this stuff has happened all the time, but with the technology, we're seeing it. And we're in the 21st century of high-tech lynching. You know, I saw the other day my man Kaepernick, quarterback of the 49ers, said that. He says 21st century lynching. And, you know, these videos, this is a real American horror show.
Van, I want to bring you into this discussion. Van Jones, President Obama said repeatedly, we can